Life's a really funny old business, isn't it? You wander along quite happily in your job all your life. You get to the point where you're about to retire. Everything's in place. And you drop dead. That's what happened to the chap who owned this camper van. It's very sad. Some kind of thrombosis, I understand. Anyway, this is Ollie. And Ollie is a 1.9 litre T25 four berth Holdsworth Villa conversion, high top. And as you can see, in really rather nice condition. Lovely thing to note about this camper is that six people can be seat belted. One, two, three, four, and then the two at the front, the driver and passenger. Cooker, two burners and a grill. He said, let there be water, and there was water. Quite a bit of pressure too, actually. You could wash your teeth in there, and a whole lot else. Showing 139,800 and something miles. A radio cassette player that works beautifully through very nice speakers. Parcel of the oddments tray, which is jolly useful, and a fan that works. This is a storage area, which, as you can see, has been racked. You can put those racks on this, on these posts, one there and one there, and that stops anything that you're storing up there flying out. Now, the previous owner also fitted them at the back because all his children used to sleep in an awning. But those could just as easily come off, and then you put a mattress of some sort. You know, most people use a blow-up mattress these days, because they're much easier. Lots of lovely storage. This is a cutlery tray. Just slides out of the way, and then you've got more storage there. And even down at the bottom. Grill pan. Hardly used, I should think. They've let out most of the time by the looks of it. More cupboard storage. A two-way fridge, meaning 12 volt or gas. Now usually they're a devil to get working on gas, but this one lit without any problems, just easy as that. Just press the button and off it went. But it's quite critical to get them level, I understand. Room for a second gas bottle. There is only one fitted, but with the regulator, so you can use it like that. Nice little tray that rolls out, good old Holdsworth, they really did do a good conversion. Lovely to see a fire extinguisher and a good sized one. Table is stowed behind this seat, between that seat and the front seat. And this whole arrangement, that whole seat, has a catch, which you can probably see there, which you can take out. Give you a bit more leg room if you want it, if you haven't got all the people with you. And then access to this cupboard through there, and the other side accessed through there. That's the pump for the water, which, as I say, works beautifully. And walking round, starting low down, just had it MOT'd. So it's MOT'd till the 30th of July next year. They commented on some surface corrosion underneath, which we've since had scraped off and undersealed. But it really is as nice as it looks. Good tyres. Rather raucous exhaust. Bit loud, bit noisy. It's not got any holes, that's how it's supposed to be. does mean you get a bit of extra power, and boy, it does pull well. 5-speed gearbox as well, which is nice. No rust at all. Not round the windows, not anywhere, and a very, very good paint finish. Two-pack paint used throughout. Windows all beautiful. I've done probably 150 miles in Ollie, and he just runs along very sweetly. Lovely to find one with proper coolant rather than water in the system, because it's essential, but this man has maintained this one so well, so nicely. And as a result, it runs really, really well. You can hear that straight away. Oh, whoops. That's running from cold. You can see the classic test. Rock solid, no movement at all, no smoke. As I said, a little bit noisier than usual, including that. And there you have Ollie.